Chapter 17. Inside the RV, Jesse and Dolly watched out the window as Bonnie's dad finished fixing the flat tire. "Come on, Woody, hurry up," Jesse said impatiently. "Where is he?" Suddenly, Buzz popped into view, startling them. "Buzz!" they shouted. They quickly helped him through the open window. "Where's Woody?" asked Dolly. "And Forky?" asked Ham. "We have a situation," said Buzz. "They need to be extracted from the antique store." "How do we do that?" asked Rex. Before Buzz could respond, the RV door opened and the family entered, causing the toys to drop into toy mode. "Okay," said Bonnie's dad, eager to hit the road. "Let's make sure we have everything." Bonnie's toys looked at Buzz with concern. Buzz whispered confidently, "It's okay." As the family began looking around, he said, "Any minute now, Bonnie will notice her backpack is missing. She'll realize she left it in the antique store and we'll head back there." "Looks like we have everything," said Bonnie's mum. "You good, Bonnie?"
"Yep,"
answered Bonnie. "Great," said Bonnie's dad. "Let's get out of here." Bonnie's mum buckled Bonnie into her car seat as her dad turned the key in the ignition. The RV engine roared to life and began to pull out of its spot. "All right, genius," whispered Ham. "What'll we do now?" Buzz frantically pushed his voice command button and listened as it said, "Scanning the perimeter." He pressed it again and it said, "Laser at full power, shields to maximum." "Buzz, what are you doing?" asked Rex.
"I'm thinking," answered Buzz.
He hit the command button yet again, causing the recorded voice to say, "This planet is toxic. Prepare for hypersleep." "Honey, will you please shut that toy off?" asked Bonnie's dad. Bonnie's mum found Buzz and picked him up. As she looked him over, trying to figure out how to turn him off, he continued to trigger his voice box, causing it to say various phrases. "Just toss it in a drawer," called Bonnie's dad. Buzz sneaked a peek out the window and saw that they were about to exit the RV park. Bonnie's mum placed him in a drawer. Having no other choice, Buzz blurted, "Your backpack's in the antique store. Let's go." Bonnie gasped and her eyes went wide. "Oh no, my backpack," she cried. Her dad stepped on the brakes. "I left my backpack in the antique store," she told her parents. "All right, let's swing by and get it," her dad said with a groan. As Woody's eyes fluttered open, he heard what sounded like an old sewing machine pedal. He looked up to see Benson biting down on a thread, cutting it off. Benson nodded, letting Woody know that the job was done. Feeling a little woozy, Woody slowly sat up and heard Gabby Gabby celebrating. She reached around to her back and tugged on her pull string. "You are my best friend. Let's play all day." The recorded voice sounded perfect. Gabby Gabby clapped her hands, bursting with happiness. "Oh, Benson, did you hear that? Did you hear it? Isn't that lovely?" She gave the string another pull, making the voice box say, "Time for tea." Gabby Gabby beamed at Woody and she thanked him. "All my dreams are coming true because of you." She threw her arms around him and hugged him tightly. Then she looked at the clock on the wall and exclaimed, "It's time, Benson." She hopped into her carriage and picked up Forky, giving him a goodbye hug. Forky wished her luck and rushed to Woody's side. The two waved goodbye as Benson wheeled Gabby Gabby away. Benson turned his head all the way around, like an owl, and looked directly at Forky. Then he attempted a smile, which caused his mouth to open stiffly and his eyebrows to wiggle. Forky giggled and whispered, "He is terrifying," as he continued to wave. Just then, the front door chimed as customers entered. Woody heard Bonnie and her mother greet Margaret. He peeked into the aisle and could see them as Bonnie's mum explained, "We called about the backpack?" "Oh yes," said Margaret. "I couldn't find it. Feel free to look around." Woody couldn't believe it. He spotted Bonnie's backpack at the far end of the aisle and urged Forky to run for it. "Quick, before she finds it." Forky began to follow him, but when he saw Gabby Gabby sitting up on a shelf across from Harmony, who was reading a book, he stopped. He watched as the doll pulled her string, making her voice box say, "You make me so happy. Let's be best friends." Hearing Gabby Gabby's voice, Harmony looked up. "Oh, this is it," Forky said excitedly. Woody didn't realize Forky wasn't with him until he had made it inside Bonnie's backpack. He looked around, confused. When he saw Forky on the other side of the aisle, he climbed back out and ran towards him. Forky pointed to Gabby Gabby and Harmony. He and Woody watched as Harmony picked up the doll and pulled her string. Her new voice box said, "I'm Gabby Gabby and I love you." "I'm gonna cry," whispered Forky, his voice trembling with emotion. "Oh, what have you got there?" asked Margaret. "I found this old doll," answered Harmony. "You can take it home if you want." Harmony looked at Gabby Gabby for only a moment before saying, "Nah, too creepy." Then she tossed Gabby Gabby into an old crate. Woody and Forky were stunned. "What happened?" asked Forky. "Gabby was supposed to be her toy." "There's my backpack," exclaimed Bonnie. Woody grabbed Forky and raced towards Bonnie's backpack as fast as he could, leaping in just a moment before she picked it up. She immediately opened it and peered inside. "Mum!" yelled Bonnie, holding Forky up. "I found him!" "There he is," said Bonnie's mum, sighing with relief. As they walked towards the exit, Woody looked through a plastic window in the backpack to see Gabby Gabby lying motionless in the old crate. "I guess you and Forky were meant to be together," Bonnie's mum added. Bonnie cheerfully tucked Forky inside her backpack. Forky looked at Woody with concern. "But what about Gabby?" he asked. Woody could never leave a toy in need behind. He knew what he had to do. He told Forky to get Buzz to bring the RV to the carousel. Woody slipped out of the backpack just as Bonnie and her mum walked out of the store. Then he headed straight towards Gabby Gabby. Gabby Gabby, slumped in the crate, said quietly as he approached, "You can have your voice box back. I don't need it anymore." "Oh yes you do," Woody said firmly. "Harmony wasn't your only chance, Gabby, but we have to hurry." Woody climbed into the crate with the doll. "What are you doing?" asked Gabby Gabby. "Shh, you hear that?" Woody said. The two listened as the faint sound of kids laughing and enjoying the carnival outside played like joyful music. Woody continued, "A friend once told me there are plenty of kids out there, and one of them is named Bonnie. She's waiting for you right now. She just doesn't know it yet." Gabby Gabby finally looked Woody in the eyes. "What if you're wrong?" asked Gabby Gabby. "Well," Woody said, standing, "if you sit on a shelf the rest of your life, you'll never find out, will ya?" "He's right," a voice said. Bo came out of the shadows and smiled at Woody. After thinking about everything that had happened between them, Bo realized that the most important thing was their friendship. Woody was always trying to do what he thought was right. She couldn't just leave him without trying to help. Woody smiled, happily surprised that she had come back. "I learned it from the best," he said. "Come on, Gabby," said Bo, holding out her hand. "Let's get you to Bonnie." Moments later, Gabby Gabby, Woody, Bo and Giggle sat inside the doll's carriage. The rest of their new friends were ready to help as well. Duke was on his stunt cycle on the floor below, and the sheep, Ducky and Bunny, were in the skunkmobile in front of him. When Bo gave the signal, the skunk took off towards the exit, with Duke racing close behind. Benson pushed the carriage and raced it forward, zooming right out the door, passing Margaret without her noticing. In the street, people jumped out of the way as the skunk raced ahead, clearing a path for the carriage behind it. Benson hung from the handles in toy mode, his body flapping around. Giggle laughed, thoroughly enjoying the wild ride as they jumped the curb and flew straight onto the carnival grounds, crashing against the side of the bounce house. The carnival goers gasped when they saw the carriage and a woman approached. "Oh, poor baby," she said. "You're okay." She pulled back the covers to see Benson sitting there with his mouth open and screamed. Bo, Woody, and the others hid safely in the shadows. "Too many people to cross," warned Giggle, surveying the scene. "Gonna need an alternate route." "Can we make it to the carousel in time?" asked Gabby Gabby. Wordlessly formulating their plan, Woody and Bo looked at each other with a grin and said, "Yes, we Canada." They smiled at Duke, who stared back confused. "What?" he said. "What is it?" Duke had no idea what Woody and Bo had in store for him. For the next chapter, click here.